فاسألوا أهل الذكر إن كنتم لا تعلمون.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والعاقبة للمتقين، ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين، وأصلي وأسلم على من بعث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. Inshallah, I'm going to answer the question, which is Ahlul, is Asha'ira from Ahlul Sunnah? Are Asha'ira from Ahlul Sunnah? The answer to this question, inshallah, is a jawab which is mujmal and a jawab which is mufassal. An answer which is general and an answer which is specific, more explained and detailed. The answer which is mujmal and general is Al-Asha'iratu laysu min Ahli Sunnah. Asha'ira are not from Ahli Sunnah. وَلَا عَلَاقَةَ لَهُمْ بِأَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ. And they have no relationship and no bond with Ahlul Sunnati whatsoever. لَا مِنْ قَرِيبٍ وَلَا مِنْ بَعِيدٍ. Not from anywhere close, nor anywhere far. And that's a general answer. The specific answer, which is jawab, which is mufassal, detailed, is as follows. Ahlul Sunnati wal Jama'ah, who are the sect which Allah subhanahu are the sect which the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said to us, لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق لا يضرهم من خذلهم ولا من خالفهم حتى يأتي أمر الله وهم على ذلك. There's always going to remain a group of people who are upon this haq. لا تزال طائفة من أمتي ظاهرين على الحق, who are always upon the haq. They are apparent on the haq, always on that path. The group that the Prophet referred to here is when he was asked, قَالُوا مَنْ هِيَ يَا رَسُولَ اللَّهِ, who are they? The Messenger said, الْجَمَاعَةِ أَهْلِ سُنَّةِ. They are the group which till the day of judgment, they are on the haq. They don't turn away from the haq. They are persistent on it. The one who tries to humiliate them, the one that tries to belittle them, the one that tries to ridicule them, the one that tries to call them names, the one that gives them titles and whatever, does not change that they are still upon the haq. لا يضرهم من خذلهم, anyone who deceives them. ولا من خالفهم, and even the one who opposes them does not harm them. They don't really care. You can call them مجسمة if you want. You can call them مشبهة if you want. You can call them names you like. لا بس. لكن حقيقة الأمر is what? They are always and they're consistent upon following the Kitab and the Sunnah. That group, we need to know, how can we recognize who they are? How can I know what Ahlul Sunnah are? Is Ahlul Sunnah something anyone who wants can just claim? Today we find a lot of groups. إِنَّ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الطَّوَائِفِ, a lot of groups. الْمُنْتَسِبَةِ لِلْإِسْلَامِ, who ascribe themselves to Islam today. تدرك فضل السلف, they recognize the virtue of the Salaf. Ah, they will say to you, Ahlul Sunnah, the Salaf of the Companions, the Tabi'een, the Atba'u Tabi'een, Allahu Akbar, great people, they will say to you. And they will mention for you, sharafahum, their honor. وعلو درجتهم, and how high the Salaf are. They'll tell that to you. But those people, they are what? بَعِيدَةٌ غَايَةَ الْبُعْدِ, but they are very far, very, very far, and what? عَنْ هَدِيهِمْ وَطَرِيقَتِهِمْ, عَنْ هَدِيهِمْ وَطَرِيقِهِمْ, they are far from their guidance and their path. Those same people who say to you, the Salaf, the Sahabas, the Tabi'een and the Atba'u Tabi'een are the best of people, and then the most righteous of people, those same people, when you look at them and you look at the Salaf, they are far from their guidance and their path. And from those people is Al-Asha'ira. وَمَنْ وَافَقَهُمْ, those who agree with them. They are what? They are far from the path of Ahlul Sunnah. Asha'ira, they mention the virtue of the Salaf. And they try to show to the people Adam and Mukhalafatim that they do not go against the Salaf. They claim that to you, we're not against the Sahabas, we're with the Sahabas. He will say to you, we are upon what the three noble generations are upon. He'll say that to you. And he will also say to you, وَأَنَّ مَذْهَبَ السَّلَفِ أَسْلَمْ, that the safest path is the path of the Salaf. They say this to you. But when you look at them and you observe them, prior to that you knew the Madhab al-Salaf in your brain, you studied it, you've looked at the Salaf's words and speeches, and then you look at the Asha'ira, you realize that they have no alaqa with them. So because of that, brothers, كَانَ الْوَاجِبُ, it is obligatory عَلَيْنَا, on every one of us, أَن نَعْرِفَ كَيْفَ يُعْرَفُ مَذْهَبِ السَّلَفِ. Because the Asha'ira deceive us and lie to us, it is obligatory on every one of us to know the methodology of the Salaf. We have to know it. حَتَّى لَا يَدَّعِي, so no one can claim أَنَّهُ عَلَى مَذْهَبِ السَّلَفِ, that he is upon the madhab of the Salaf. وَالْأَمْرُ لَيْسَ كَذَلِكَ, and the matter really isn't as he claims. What is the madhab of Salaf? Or how is the madhab of Salaf recognized? Brothers, madhab al-Salafi, the methodology of the Salaf al-Salih, إِنَّمَا يُعْرَفُ, it is recognized, it is known by what? بِالْآثَارِ الْمَنْقُولَةِ, by the texts which are transmitted to us regarding them. We know the madhab of the Salaf by that which has been transmitted to us regarding them. لَا بِمُجَرَّدِ دَعْوَى, not just a mere claim that the Salaf used to believe this, or that I'm upon what the Salaf are. The matter of the Salaf is known by transmitting to us what they were upon. The matter is not bimujarradi da'wa, claim. Everyone can claim something. Claiming is an easy thing to do. Claiming? It's an easy thing every single person can do. But we need a miqyas, maqayis. We need to scale, we need to weigh. So Salaf, we need them, their speech to be transmitted to us. Ahlul Kalam, such as Asha'ira, the Mu'tazila, the Jahmiyyah, and the likes of them, وَمَنْ عَلَىٰ طَرِيقَتِهِمْ, and anyone who's upon their path, they will not transmit to you the speech of the Salaf. Ah, they won't. We'll see that, inshallah. Al-Imam Ad-Darimi, rahimahullah ta'ala. Al-Imam Ad-Darimi, rahimahullah. Al-Imam Ad-Darimi, rahimahullah. He has a book called Ar-Raddu al-Jahmiyyah. Al-Imam Ad-Darimi. There's a book called Ar-Raddu al-Jahmiyyah, the refutation upon the Jahmiyyah. He said in his book, what is he going to tell us? How to recognize the madhab of the Salaf. He's going to tell us. Look what he says. He says, this is while he was refuting the Jahmiyyah. He said, فَالْمَعْقُولُ, the logic. The logic. عِنْدَنَا, according to us. And Imam Ad-Darimi is min a'immati Salaf. He said, فَالْمَعْقُولُ, the logic, عِنْدَنَا, according to us, مَا وَافَقَ هَدْيَهُمْ, it is what is in agreement to the Sahabas and the Tabi'een, what is in accordance to their guidance. That is logic to us. Good. وَالْمَجْهُولُ, something that is unknown to us, something that is anonymous to us, anonymous, is مَا خَالَفَهُمْ, is what opposes them. Anything that opposes them for us is in what? It's majhul, it's unknown. It is what? It is unknown. Here's the speech. وَلَا سَبِيلَ, and there is no way. إِلَى مَعْرِفَةِ هَدِيهِمْ, there is no way to know their guidance. وَطَرِيقَتِهِمْ, and their path. إِلَّا هَذِهِ الْآثَارَ, except with these evidences, these texts that have been transmitted to us regarding them. There is no other way to know them except that. Allahu Akbar. Dhahabi rahimahullah ta'ala, Imam al-Dhahabi, in his kitab Al-Ulu li'Ali al-Ghaffar, Al-Ulu li'Ali al-Azim, however you call it, Imam al-Darimi rahimahullah, he said that in his kitab Ar-Radd al-Jahmiyyah, the speech I just currently mentioned, in page 127 to 128. Dhahabi rahimahullah, he said in his kitab Al-Ulu, he said, فَإِنْ أَحْبَبْتَ, if you love, Ya Abdullah, the servant of Allah, he's talking to you. Imam Dhahabi, rahimahullah, Ghaniyun 'ani at-ta'rif. Dhahabi, I don't think, requires us to explain who he is. And Imam al-Dhahabi was one of the students of Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah, rahimahullah ta'ala. Min talamidati Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. He studied and graduated from that madrasa. And he praises him, rahimahullah, rahmatan wasi'ah. Praises him highly. Highly praises Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah. Rather, he praised ibn Taymiyyah after ibn Taymiyyah died. فَإِنْ أَحْبَبْتَ If you wish, and you have love. يَا عَبْدَ اللَّهِ The servant of Allah. الْإِنصَافَ Insaf is a person who's munsif. Munsif is a person who is just. Just. If you want to come with insaf, and you want to be just and fair, do what? فَقِفْ Stand over. مَعَ نُصُوصِ الْقُرْآنِ Stand over the text of the Qur'an. وَالسُّنَنِ And the sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم. Is that all? لا. ثُمَّ انظُرْ After that look. مَا قَالَهُ الصَّحَابَةُ That which the Sahabas have said. وَالتَّابِعُونَ And the students of the Sahabas. وَأَئِمَّةُ التَّفْسِيرِ And the scholars of tafsir. فِي هَذِهِ الْآيَاتِ Regarding these verses. وَمَا حَكَوْهُ And that which they have informed us. مِنْ مَذَاهِبِ السَّلَفِ From the methodology of the Salaf. Allahu Akbar. He tells us to stand over the Kitab and the Sunnah first. Then when you stand over the Kitab and the Sunnah, do you run it and do you rush it to your own personal understandings? Do you rush it to the mere Arabic language? La, 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 la. Take it back to who? Take it, look, as soon as you get the ayah and the hadith, look at who? انظر ما قاله الصحابة. Look at what the companions have said. والتابعون And the students of the Sahabas. What have they said regarding this verse? وَأَئِمَّةُ التَّفْسِيرِ And the scholars of tafsir. Who are the أَئِمَّةُ التَّفْسِيرِ Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, رحمه الله, Ibn Abi Hatim, and the likes of these scholars. Who, their books are called what? تفسير المأثور. Ibn Jarir al-Tabari. Every ayah, he will bring you the aqwal of the Salaf regarding this ayah. Good. في هذه الآيات regarding these verses, take it back to the أَئِمَّةُ التَّفْسِيرِ. وَمَا حَكَوْهُ And that which they have informed you, the أَئِمَّةُ التَّفْسِيرِ And the Sahabas, and the Tabi'in, what they tell you, that they believe, take it from them. This is the madahib al-salafi. So what have we come to know from all of this, brothers? فَاتَّضَحَ مِمَّا سَبَقَ It has become clear to us regarding the speech of Imam al-Darimi, rahimahullah, and the speech of who? As Imam al-Dhahabi, rahimahullah. And they're not only the two. Like, we don't want to go too much into it. And قوام السنة, قوام السنة, Abu Qasim al-Taymi, He has a book called Al-Hujjah fi Bayan al-Mahajjah. He has a book called Al-Hujjah fi Bayan al-Mahajjah. He also says the same thing that way they said. Abu Qasim, Hibatullah ila Lakai, and his kitab, Sharh Usul I'tiqad Ahli Sunnah, he also says the same. Ibn Battal al-Akburi, rahimahullah. If you go, you find kalam regarding the madhab al-Salafi, how it's recognized. فَتَضَحَ It became clear. مِمَّا سَبَقَ That which has preceded. أَنَّ مَذْهَبَ السَّلَفِ The methodology of the Salaf, يُعْرَفُ It is recognized بِأَقْوَالِهِمُ الْمَأْثُورَةِ عَنْهُمْ The speeches which have been transmitted to us regarding them. That's how we know it. Good. In what way? بِنَقْلِ الْعَدْلِ عَنِ الْعَدْلِ A chain of narration where reliable narrates from a reliable, narrates from a reliable. Oh! That's one way. Oh! That he said as well. The second one is what? أو بمن حكى أقوالهم or anyone who informs us of the madhab of the Salaf but he has to be what? ممن كان whoever is what? موثوقا في نقلي the part where he said وأئمة التفسير في هذه الآيات وما حكوا من مذاهب السلف the Salaf them saying themselves this is what we believe this is our madhab this is our belief one the second one is a person who comes later informs you and this person is a reliable individual he will come and tell you this is what the Salaf believed This is the belief of the Salaf. This is what the Sahabas believed. This is what the Tabi'in believed. This person is what? Mawthuqan fi naqli. He's a reliable person in the way he transmits his information. Not a person. La man urifa bi da'fi fi ma'rifati al-athar. Not a person who's weak in having the understanding and the comprehension of what? The text of the Salaf. He doesn't even understand it. Ah. One of the people, subhanAllah, that walil asaf al-shadid, very sad, who you find today, channels like, for example, Hanafi channel, مثلاً, who promote this Ash'ari belief. They promote this, it's called Hanafi Fiqh. They promote Ash'ari belief. One of the people that they go back to try to bring to your eyes, they want to tell you that the Salaf, what they believe, and they bring this person to you and say to you, he said that the Salaf used to believe this. Such as who? Muhammad Zahid al-Kawthari. Muhammad Zahid al-Kawthari. One has to open his eyes and realize who this man is. The filth and the khubth in this man. This man insulted 300 Salaf. 300 men from the time of the Salaf. From them who? Anas ibn Malik. Shafi'i. Malik ibn Anas. All of that, why did he do it for? Just to defend Abu Hanifa. Imam Abu Hanifa is Imam Mubajjal. Imam Abu Hanifa is an Imam. La shakka wa la rayb. Noble Imam. A matter, his ijalala and his makana la yantadhu fi kabshan. Abu Hanifa la shakka min a'immah al-matbu'in. He's from the four a'immah that are followed. Like Muhammad Zahid al-Kawthari al-Khabith. Al-Halik. If you read it, there's a book written by Abdul Rahman ibn Yahya al-Muallimi. He called it At-Tankilu. Bima fi At-Tankilu. والتأنيب بما في لا يكون التنكيل بما في تأنيب الكوثري من الأباطيل التنكيل بما في تأنيب الكوثري من الأباطيل. He talks about the book التأنيب الخطيب البغدادي where محمد زايد الكوثري came refuted خطيب البغدادي إمام من أئمة of حديث 300 men. عبد الرحمن يحيى المعلمي came and he took one man after man. The way he plays around with the hadith and his ignorance of it, and how he plays around with it. Are you with me? One of the people that today is alive, Muhammad Zahid al-Kawthari died. One of the people that are alive today that took that banner from Muhammad Zahid al-Kawthari recently, who's still alive, who even now has an inclination of rafd and tashayyu, tashi'ism in him, is Hassan ibn Ali al-Saqqaf. Hassan ibn Ali al-Saqqaf. Go to Hanafi channel, they promote him, and they refer to him as a Hassan ibn Ali al-Saqqaf. ما حاله واستسحال حسن علي سقاف insulted معاوية بن أبي سفيان رضي الله تعالى عنه. They honor him. So are these people we can say, people who are موثوقا في نقله, who are reliable in what they transmit, not people who are weak in the understanding of the athar of the Salaf? لا شك, these people are evil. They're not the people we take our knowledge from. نعم. السفاريني رحمه الله say something. الإمام السفاريني رحمه الله. He's a book called لوامع الأنوار. He said المراد بمذهب السلف. What is meant by the مذهب of the سلف? What is meant by it? He said ما كان عليه الصحابة. It is that which the صحابة were upon. الكرام, the honorable companions. وأعيان التابعين, and the individuals of the تابعين. لهم بإحسان, those of righteousness and good. وأئمة الدين, and the أئمة, the scholars of this religion. مِمَّنْ شُهِدَ لَهُمْ بِالْإِمَامَةِ, those who have been witness for them, that they are a'imma, they have witnesses. No but other scholars have witnessed for them that they are a'imma. وَعُرِفَ عِظَمُ شَأْنِهِمْ, and it has been known the high rank of their affairs in the religion, في الدين. وَتَلَقَّ النَّاسُ كَلَامَهُمْ, and the people have transmitted to one another their speeches. خَلَفًا عَنْ سَلَفْ, from latecomers, from those who were before them. دون besides مرومي ببدعة, there was not amongst them anyone who was thrown at him any form of innovation. They weren't بدعة, weren't in these people. Now brothers, the first point of the issue is that I mentioned, which is how is the madhab of the Salaf recognized? كيف يعرف مذهب السلف? How can the madhab of the Salaf be known? What did we learn? That the madhab of Salaf is known by two ways. One is that the Salaf themselves state their own belief and their methodology. They state it. One. The second one is that it is transmitted to us from a person who is mawthuqan, who is reliable. We studied the word thiqa, right? Thiqa is a person who has two titles. He has dabd, which is tam, and he has adala, those two. And remember, we said any hadith or any individual who is criticized, or any hadith which is weakened, it's weakened for two reasons. أَطَعْنُ فِي الرَّاوِيُّ أَوْ سَقْطُ فِي السَّنَدْ, a criticism towards the narrator, or a chain of narration is disconnected. The narrator who is criticized, pay attention, it's important that you understand this, he's criticized from two angles. إِمَّا فِي ضَبْطِهِ, either his memory, or her what? Or his adala. And each one has five that come below it. Each one has five, in which that comes out of it, meaning dabt, his memory, and then five that come from his adala. any individual who is being criticized, this narrator, there's a ta'an on him, criticism that is put on him. That narrator, the criticism that has been put to him is a criticism that comes min qibal hifzih, from the angle of his memory, or from the angle of what? His morality and his adala. Pay attention to this. It's important. The person who is adala is on point, and his dabt is on point, who has no ta'an on him, what does he become? He becomes a thiqah. He becomes a thiqah. The person we want who transmits to us, the salaf, has to be a thiqah. In his hifz, and his itqan, and also in what? In his dabt, and his adala. Pay attention. Those are the two ways to know the madhab of salaf. Now we're going to move on to what is the madhab of the salaf in the characteristics of Allah. Bayanu madhab al-salafi fi sifati Allah. Clarifying, inshallah, the methodology of the salaf in the attributes of Allah, in the sifat, the characteristics of Allah. We don't want nobody latecomers. We will just bring you the salaf. Bi asanida, chains of narration which are all authentic. Every quote that I bring is authentic. Ah. Wallahi, if it wasn't for the sake of tatweel, that it would become long, me to go into it. Each chain of narration I can study it with you, and I can tell you rijal, rajulan, rajula. Man, each man we could do his tarjama by himself. To show you that these asanid and these ahadith are authentic. And the quotes that I'm going to bring. Who are the group that we're talking about right now? We're talking about the Asha'ira. The Asha'ira. Inshallah ta'ala, I will talk about the story of the Asha'ira in details, their name, where it comes from, who do they ascribe themselves to. We don't really, because it's just a question that was asked. So I'm just going to go over it fast and quick, just to explain to you how Ahlul Sunnah, the way Ahlul Sunnah were regarding the attributes of Allah, Tabarak wa ta'ala, his characteristics. Keep in mind, the Asha'ira, what do they believe in the characteristics of Allah? They believe that the characteristics of Allah, there are two paths which are open for them, in which they tread on, two ways. One is called tariqatu ta'wil, and we're going to come to that, inshallah ta'ala. Ta'wil is one of the ways that they resort to. One of the ways they resort to is called is ta'wil. So they say, this characteristics of Allah, it means this. So for example, they will stand over the word yad, hand. And he will say to you, the hand here is meant by qudra, ability. Or it's meant by what? Or it's meant by bounty, which is ni'mah. This is now called ta'wil. Remember, the ta'wil I'm referring to is because sometimes the word ta'wil can mean tafsir. And that is that istilah, the terminology according to the sahab, the salaf. The way they knew the word ta'wil was what? At tafsir. So for example, if you go to Muhammad ibn Jarir al-Tabari, rahimahullah, in his tafsir, what does he say to the ayah when he's doing the tafsir? He says, وَتَأْوِيلُ قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى. He's not referring to the ta'wil that I'm talking about here. He means the tafsir. Even his tafsir book is called a ta'wil. Jami'u ta'wil al-Qur'an. Ta'wil al-Qur'an. Tafsir al-Qur'an. The ta'wil I'm talking about is not that one now. The ta'wil I'm referring to here is what? Is the ta'wil that the mutaakhirin, the latecomers, have introduced, which is, what does it mean? Sarfu al-lafzi. It is to divert the word. From what? Anil ihtimal al-rajihi. From the most strongest indication, or the biggest, the meaning that comes to the mind, you take it away from that one, and you take it towards what? إلى الاحتمال المرجوح, to a interpretation or a meaning which is the weaker of the two. And inshallah, we will say it. We'll come to inshallah when we speak about their shubuhat and their points. The second one they have is what is known as tafwil. What is tafwil? Tafwid, now we're not talking about tafwidul kayf. Tafwidul kayf, Ahlul Sunnah believe that. Labas. Tafwidul kayf is to say the how, Allahu A'lam. The how, Allahu A'lam. Allah knows what he means by it. Allah knows how his hand looks like. We don't know it. The how, Allahu A'lam. We don't know it. Ahlul Sunnah believe that. Tafwidul kayf, labas abi. Lakin tafwidul ma'na, the meaning, is not known. The meaning is not known at all. That's not tariqah to Ahlul Sunnah. And I'm going to bring my evidence for this. Ash-Sha'ira believe tafwidul ma'na, or They believe at-ta'wil. And they do tanaquf. How can both of that be present? So ta'wil means, is to say, when you come to the ayah, Allahu a'lam, we don't know what it means, move it. So when Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, bal yadahu mabsuutatani, Allah's two hands are open. They'll say to Allah, a'lam, Allah knows what he means by this. We don't know it. We don't know. And once, if they want, what would they say? It means ni'mah or qudrah. So how can it be both at the same time, ya asha'ira? How can you take a tariqah to ta'wil and tariqah to tafwid at the same time? And naqidani la yajtami'an. Two opposites cannot come together. Two opposites don't come together. And they're going to show a'immatu salaf. A'immatu salaf. Yaqtasiruna fi ithbati al-asma'i wa sifat. Ahli sunnah, salaf, wa salih. They believed about Allah's names and characteristics what? They believed about the qa'ida, which is Allah's names are what? A'lamu bi'itibari dalalatiha ala al-dhati. Wa awsafun bi'itibari dalalatiha ala al-ma'ani. Inshallah, we will explain it more in our kitab, which we were doing, Aqidatul Wasitiyah. Allah's names, every name of Allah has a characteristic that's brought out of it. Allah's names are, they're not mujarrad al-a'lam. Allah's names are not just pure, just mere names. Every name of Allah has a characteristics out of it. Ar-Rahman, sifatul rahmah. Ar-Rahman, sifatul rahmah. Ash-Sha'ira, I'm not like that. They have seven type of characteristics which they call sifat dhatiyya, in which they affirm for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Those seven characteristics are the only seven in which they affirm for Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. The rest, tafwil, ta'wil, tafwil, ta'wil, and they got themselves tired. They got themselves tired. So, tariqatu ahli sunnah, what is it? Amma madhhabu salafi regarding the names of Allah is what? A'immatu salaf ithbatu, to affirm to Allah. Ma athbatahu li nafsi. Anything Allah affirmed for himself in terms of characteristics and attributes, Ahli Sunnah say, Ya Rabbi, you know yourself more than we do. We will take these characteristics from you. Ithbatullahi, to affirm for Allah, to establish for Allah that which he mentioned of himself. Also, to affirm for him that which his messenger affirmed for him. And to negate from Allah that which he negated from himself. And to negate from Allah that which the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam negated from him. Al-Sunnah, the Salaf, the Ithbat, and the Nafi, the affirmation, and the negation, they took it from Allah and the Messenger. They did not affirm that which Allah and the Messenger did not affirm. They did not negate that which Allah and His Messenger did not negate. Ash'ara, what do? They affirm what they like. They negate what they like. For example, I'm going to give you the question that was put to me as well, which another is a question that can be all put together, is the word, and you hear it a lot, and you're going to hear it a lot, which is what? The word mujassim, jism, jiha, direction. Jism is a body. Now, I, Abdurrahman, look in the Quran and the Sunnah, and I do not find the word jism in the Quran or the Sunnah. Are you with me? Am I going to affirm it? No. Also, the Quran and the Sunnah do not negate the word jism. Am I going to negate it?
No.
See? Ahlu Sunnah, tariqatu Ahlu Sunnah is this. Why are we bringing this term in? Who told you to negate it? Another one affirms it. Who told you to affirm it? Two people. One is affirming, one is negating it. Where's your delete to affirm it? The other one negates it. Hey, where's your evidence to negate it? Anyone who comes to you and says the word jism, say, where's your delete to affirm it? The one that affirms it, Allah has a jism. You say, brother, where is this view? Where did you get this from? The kitab and the sunnah. And the aqwal as-salaf. Are you with me? The one who negates it, you say, bro, this is the characteristics of Allah you're talking about. Ah. Where did you get from Allah, negating it from Allah? Does that make sense? Salaf, they only stuck to what the text mentioned. They affirmed it. And whatever the text negated, they negated it. And they did not move beyond that. هذا طريقة السلف. And they didn't run to what? To say that this characteristic means this. And run to what is known as ta'wil, which I mentioned, or tafwil. And I'm going to give you an example. Huh? That which is a دلالة واضحة على أن الواجب هو. That it is إجراء النصوص على ظاهرها كما هي طريقة أئمة السلف. that their text regarding Allah's characteristics and attributes, huh, should be affirmed. And it's apparent. According to the language. Pay attention, brothers. Allah ascribed for himself what? A hand. Is hand in the Arabic language know what it is? In the language, is it known what the word, does the word hand is in the Arabic language? Yed. Is it known in the Arabic language? Naam. We affirm it what is in the language. As for the how? Allahu A'lam. We don't know the how. Are you with me? Are you all with me? Do I affirm a hand for you? Do I affirm a hand for the clock? Yes. The isbat here is isbat am, a general affirmation. I affirmed for you a hand, and I affirmed for the clock a hand. Ishtirakun fil ismi la yadullu ala ishtiraku fil kayfi. Just because you both have in common the name, it doesn't mean the how is the same. Sah? The characteristics of the hand for the clock, it is what? Yaliqu bi bidati. It befits the clock itself. The hand of you, yours, it befits who? Yours. As for the Asha'ira, the affirming of the characteristics is automatically attached to their brains. Ithbatu sifa, straight away what connects to it is tashbih. So when they say Allah is hand, straight away is tashbih. Does that make sense? هذا ليس بطريقة أهل السنة. And a delil for this is what? This is the delil to show you. When the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, a Bedouin, Arab Bedouin would come to him. Bedouin, does he not know the language? The Arabs were? They were fusaha. They were eloquent. Huh? As the Bedouin once said, he said, لَسْتُ بِنَحْوِيٍّ يَلُوكُ لِسَانَهُ وَلَكِنِّي سَلِيقِيٍّ أَقُولُ فَأُعْرِبُ. I'm not a grammarian. He's a Bedouin. He said, I ain't grammarian. I didn't study Mabni al-Mu'rab. I didn't study Alamat al-I'rab. I didn't study Mamnu' min al-Sarf al-Alamiyya wal-Wasfiyya. I didn't study the Tanween al-Tamkeen and Tanween al-Nakira. I didn't study that. Lakinni Saliqi. I'm a Saliqi from the angle of what? I'm a person who speaks the Arabic. Whenever I speak it, I won't get it wrong grammatically. But there's no grammar I follow because he doesn't know the grammar in it. Grammar was made for foreigners, people who are not Arabs. So this you have to keep in mind. That same Bedouin or those types of Bedouins will come to the Messenger, alayhi salatu wasalam. And what would he tell them? فَيُخْبِرُهُمْ The Prophet said, فَيُخْبِرُهُمْ النَّبِيُّ صلى الله عليه وسلم بِنُصُوصِ الصِّفَاتِ The Messenger will tell that man what? That Bedouin, the characteristics of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. مُعْتَمِدًا The Prophet said, will tell him. Prophet, when he's telling him, what's he relying on? في بيان تلك النصوص على ما يتبادر إلى ذهن ذلك السامع من لسان العربي. Because he's an Arab, he's going to take it according to the Arabic language what the word yad means. صحيح. He's going to take it according to the Arabic language. ولا يصرفها. And this, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم will not say to me, Bedouin. Just in case your brain might take it as though this is حقيقة. It's مجاز. Where does the Prophet ever say that? Every characteristic that the Messenger ever mentioned, never did he say it is majaz. It's a metaphor. It's not its apparent. Haqiqatan, that it's literal. The Prophet never said, no, this is not literal to the Bedouin. To show you what? Leave the characteristics at its apparent. Follow it what it means according to the language, but the how? يَلِيقُ بِصِفَاتِ It befits what? يَلِيقُ بِجَلَالَتِهِ It befits his subhanahu wa ta'ala, his... It befits him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, his majesty. For example, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala said in the Qur'an, Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said in the Qur'an, هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاهُ مِنْ نُطْفَةٍ Who is he talking about? Al-insan, the surah is called surah al-insan, sahih? هَلْ أَتَى عَلَى الْإِنسَانِ حِينٌ مِّنَ الدَّهْرِ لَمْ يَكُنْ شَيْئًا مَذْكُورًا إِنَّا خَلَقْنَاهُ We created it. من نطفة we create him from نطفة إنا خلقناه من نطفة أمشاج نبتليه فجعلناه we made the human what فجعلناه سميعا one that can hear بصيرا one that can see so what did Allah affirm for the human السمع والبصر hearing and seeing correct Allah also affirmed it for himself ليس كمثله شيء nothing is like Allah وهو السميع البصير Allah is the Uhiyah and Usiyah. Hey, how do you distinguish between the two characteristics? We say, Ya Barakallah Fiqh, Sifatu Sam'i wa Sifatu Al-Basari. For Allah Tabaraka wa Ta'ala, Yaliqu bi Jalalihi, befits His Majesty. As for the human, it befits His Majesty. Does Allah exist? Ya Ash'ari, Ya Ash'ari. Does Allah exist, Subhanahu wa Ta'ala? Na'am. Allah exists. Jameel. Do I exist? Na'am. How do you distinguish between the two? Wujudullahi, Allah's existence. Wa wujudul makhluqeen, and the existence of the creation. Kayfa tufarriq. How do you distinguish between the two? The existence and the existence here. The tafriq is what? Again, that this existence befits the creation. And this existence befits Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala. Everyone's existence is different. Why? Allah's existence is different from yours. Lam yasbuq. Allah's existence, it didn't come before it. Adam, when there wasn't a time when he didn't exist. Your existence prior to it is what? Adam, a time you didn't exist. So there's a farq already. But you both share in common what? Existence. So again, learn this qa'ida. Al-ishtiraku. Sharing the name does not necessitate the sharing of the how. It doesn't mean the how is the same. That is an important point you need to understand. Now I'm going to mention some aqwal of the Salaf regarding the names and the attributes of Allah, which they did not distort. I'm going to mention a couple of aqwal of the Salaf. Let me come to the ayah, which is very highly disputed. Which is the qawluhu ta'ala, where Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he says, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 29, Ar-Rahmanu ala al-arshi istawa. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said, sorry, in Surah Al-Baqarah, he says, istawa ila al-samai. Istawa ila al-samai. Istawa ila al-samai. And talking about Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 29. Istawa ila al-samai. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala went above his throne. Went above the sky. استوى إلى السماء. أبو عالية. أبو عالية الرياحي. أبو عالية الرياحي. His name is رفيع بن مهران. أبو عالية الرياحي. كان ابن عباس يرفعني على سريره وقريش أسفل منه ويقول هكذا العلم يزيد الشرف الشريف شرفا. عبد الله بن عباس. أبو عالية says about himself. He said that he used to lift me up on a سرير. He used to put him on a sarir. And he would say to him, and Quraysh were beneath, the bottom. And you know what he used to say, Ibn Abbas, to him, putting him on a high place. He used to say, هَكَذَا الْعِلْمُ this, like this is knowledge, that it honors the honorable one. Yeah. And then he's trying to say that the chair, the sarir, is where the ruler sits on. Huh? So respecting him. Abu Aliyah, مُجْمَعٌ. It's unanimously agreed upon his thiqah, reliable. Imam min aimah. And it's from Rijal al-Bukhari. Imam al-Bukhari quotes him in the Sahih. Abu Aliyah, when it came to the ayah, istawa ila al-sama'i, what did he say? Irtafa'a. Allah went above. He said, irtafa'a. Bukhari narrated in his Sahih, ta'liqan. When it came to the ayah, wa kana arshu ala al-ma'. Bukhari brought it under that kitab al-tawheed. Babu, wa kana arshu ala al-ma'. Bukhari was saying to you clearly, Imam Muhammad ibn Ismail ibn Ibrahim al-Bukhari al-Bardizba was saying to you that Allah is above his throne. Imam Bukhari. So Imam Bukhari is a Wahhabi? Is Imam al-Bukhari a Wahhabi? Who is first, Wahhabi or Imam Bukhari? You probably find somebody say he is. So Imam Bukhari narrated that. Mujahid ibn Jabr. Who's Mujahid? Those who study usul al-tafsir with me will know. Mujahid is the man Sufyan al-Thawri rahimahullah, he said to you, إِذَا جَاءَكَ تَفْسِيرُ مُجَاهِدٍ فَعَسْبُكَ بِهِ إِذَا جَاءَكَ تَفْسِيرُ مُجَاهِدٍ. If the tafsir of Mujahid comes to you, it's sufficient. Don't look for more. Why are you looking for more? Tafsir of Mujahid comes to you. Who is Mujahid? He speaks about himself. He said, عَرَضْتُ الْمُصْحَفَ عَلَى ابْنِ عَبَّاسِ. You can say, عَرَضْتُ الْمَصْحَفَ or مِصْحَفَ or مُصْحَف. The word مُصْحَف is a مثلث. It's a مثلث. You can pronounce it three ways. He said, I opened the مُصْحَف on ابْنِ عَبَّاسِ. ثلاث عرضات, three times from beginning to end. أقف عند كل آية. Every ayah, I stand over it. أسأله فيما نزلت. I ask him, who did this come down on? وأين نزلت? Where has it come down? وكيف نزلت? How did it come down? He died the year 103. Go to the Kitab Tadhkiratul Huffaz. Dhahabi Rahimullah, in his Kitab Tadhkiratul Huffaz, he brings the Huffaz of Hadith in that book. Dhahabi Rahimullah. Mujahid, when it came to the ayah, what did he say? Istawa. Ayah, what did he say? Bukhari quoted it again. Bukhari brought him and Abu Ali's speech in his Kitab, Sahih al-Bukhari, Ta'liqan, fi Kitab al-Tawheed, Babu, wa kana arshu ala al-ma'. He brought it that he said ala, above. The scholars, what did they do? They took the speech of Abu Aliya and they took the speech of Mujahid, and when they speak about the ayah, what did they say? Ar-Rahmanu ala al-arsh istawa ala wartafa. Ala wartafa. The two imams, Abu Aliya and Mujahid, huh? They took these characteristics that Allah is above his throne. They didn't take the filthy, corrupted path of the Asha'ira, which is to do what? Ta'wil. They didn't do ta'wil. They didn't say istawa means istawla. Huh? If you think and you ponder, every person who goes against the path of Ahlul Sunnah, tariqatu Ahlul Sunnah, wallahi will be forced to resemble and to look like the disbelievers, without a shadow of a doubt. Look at what they did. They said istawa means istawla. They added an additional lam to it. Ibn al-Qayyim said, nunul yahudi wa lamul jahmiyya huma fil qur'ani za'idatani. The noon of Jahmiyyah. The noon of Yahud. Yahud, what did they do? When Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala said to them, go to inside Baytul Maqdis and go, and whilst you're going in, come into a position of prostration. Prostrate when you're going in. And say, Hitta. What did they say? Hinta. They added a noon to it. Allah told them, said Hitta. They said Hinta out of mockery and istihza. Also, what did they do? They didn't prostrate. The Jahmiyyah, who are the teachers of the Asha'ira, that's where they took their corruption from. Ah. What did the Asha'ira do? They added a lam and the Jahmiyyah, the lam to istawa. What did they say? It's istawla. And what does istawla mean? Allah took over the throne. Somebody owned it, Allah took it over from them. They were asked, okay, Jimmy, stop. Where did you get this understanding from? Remember, we said Madhab al-Salaf is what? Hadith. Ayah or hadith, right? Or the aqwal of the sahabas and tabi'in, right? That's Ahlul Sunnah, right? Is that tariqah to Ahlul Sunnah? Did we just mention that? وَالسَّابِقُونَ الْأَوَّلُونَ مِنَ الْمُهَاجِرِينَ وَالْأَنصَارِ وَالَّذِينَ اتَّبَعُوهُمْ. And the ones who followed the muhajirin and the ansar. وَمَنْ يُشَاقِقِ الرَّسُولَ مِنْ بَعْدِ مَا تَبَيَّنَ لَهُ الْهُدَى وَيَتَّبِعْ, and he follows, غَيْرَ السَّبِيلِ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, other than the path of the believers. What believers is the ayah referring to? What believers were alive at that time when the ayah was coming down? The sahabas, they weren't under any other believers other than them. So who follows a path other than the believers? So it's the sahabas and every other believers that come after later, inshallah ta'ala. إِلَىٰ أَنْ يَرِثَ اللَّهُ الْأَرْضَ وَمَنْ عَلَيْهَا. For Allah to take over this earth and take it over. Here, Asha'ira, when we asked them, who told you the istawa is istawla? They did not go to the Kitab. They did not go to the Sunnah. Nor did they go back to the Salaf al-Salih. They went to what? They went back to a poet. Okay. Who is a Christian poet. Who believed in what? Who believed in the Trinity. Can you claim a group like that are Ahlul Sunnah? When they don't, they go against Tariqah to Ahli Sunnah. Are you with me? So then we said, okay, no problem. What? Tell us what the poetry that you're talking about is. They said, Ghayath ibn Ghayyuth. Huh? They said, Istawa Bishrun ala al-Iraqi. Bishr took over Iraq. Istawa Bishrun ala al-Iraqi. Min ghayri sayfin wala damin muhraqin. Without any blood shed or no fighting. So they said, istawa is used in this poetry, they said. Here, it means istawla, he took over. Are you with me? Rather, just so you guys also know, in the Diwan, in the Diwan of Ghayath ibn Ghayyuth al-Salt, it's not even written there. In his Diwan, his book of poetry, where he wrote his poetries, that is not even in there. That line of poetry is not in there. So even if we just take it for the sake of argument, you go against an ayah which is sarih, that is apparent. You go against it. You go against the tafsir of the salaf of this ummah, Abu Aliya, Mujahid, and you take the tafsir of who? ولذلك ابن تيمية said, what did he say in Islamiyah? He said, قبح لمن نبذ القرآن وراءه وإذا استدل يقول قال الأخضل. Destruction be to the one. قبح لمن نبذ القرآن وراءه. He tosses the Quran over his shoulder. وإذا استدل, when he wants to use it as evidence, what do you say? He says, قال الأخضل. أخضل said, أخضل is غياث بن غيوث. غيوث السلت. He said, أخضل said. He uses him as an evidence over the book of Allah تبارك وتعالى and the Sunnah of the Messenger صلى الله عليه وسلم and the أقوال of the Sahaba and the تابعين and the تابعين. But we, inshallah, والله الحمد لله. What do? We go back to the Salaf and we quote what they said. We've got Abu Ali and his kalam. And we also have Mujahid and that which he said. They took it to its apparent. If you look at Al-Bayjuri, he has a book called Jawharatul Tawheed. Jawharatul Tawheed. Jawharatul Tawheed. Which is a sharh of Ibrahim Al-Laqqani's kitab. He does a sharh of Jawharatul Tawheed by Ibrahim Al-Laqqani. Bayjuri, what does he say? He said, وَكُلُّ أَوْهَمَ He's an Ash'ari. He said, وَكُلُّ أَوْهَمَ التَّشْبِيهَ Everything that, any verse that you come across, and it gives you that feeling that there is like a tashbih, huh? resembling the characteristics of Allah to the creation, tashbih might come into it. What do? أَوِّلْهُ دُو تَأْوِيلْ فَوِّضْهُ دُو تَفْوِيلْ وَرُمْ تَنْزِيهَا And remove from Allah تبارك وتعالى this resemblance. هذا طريقة الأشاعرة. أشاعرة Ibrahim al-Laqqani and Bayjuri, these are the scholars, these are the ulama that they go back to. You see? Now, this issue allows you to know, Ahlul Sunnah are not like that. And that's Mujahid and Abu Aliya saying to you, ala, taking istawa at its apparent meaning. Istawa doesn't carry any other meaning when it's in this context. The way it is istawa ala. Good. What about the word? Another two more examples, inshallah, that the Salaf were like this. The first, the third one is the qawl of Abdullah ibn Umar ibn Khattab. I can give you a lot, but I'm just going to do some. Abdullah ibn Umar ibn Khattab, radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. Al-Imam al-Darimi, he bases it is refutation on Bishr al-Barisi, al-Ajur in Kitab al-Sharia, and al-Lalaka'i, Abu Qasim, Hibatullah al-Lalaka'i in his Kitab, Sharh Usul al-Itqad Ahli Sunnati. He brings Abdullah ibn Umar said, خلق الله الله created أربعة أشياء four things Allah created بيده with his hand you can't say this hand is here right now means قدرة or ability so what does it mean pay attention if you say that the yed the hand means قدرة and ability the rest of it an ability or نعمة blessing Allah created everyone else with his ability and Allah created everyone else with blessings why these four uniquely قدرة and ability so the rest there was no ability involved does that make sense you can't exclusively But look at the Sahabas, they didn't go to that the belief of the Ash'ara and their way of dealing with the Nusus. He said, خَلَقَ اللَّهُ أَرْبَعَةَ أَشْيَاءَ Allah created four things with his hands. Which one? Is it Adam? Adam, when Allah says, خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيَّ I created you. Like, خَلَقْتُ بِيَدَيَّ I created him with my two hands. That's what Allah, تبارك وتعالى, he said in the Quran. Ibrahim, Nabiullah Adam alayhi salam, Adam alayhi salam has a unique thing over the rest of us. He, Allah, created with his hand, not us. We were kun fayakun. Four things Allah created with his hand. The second one is al-arsh, the throne. Third, al-qalam, the pen. And the fourth one, which is what? Wa jannatu adnin, and the jannat of adn. Thumma qala li sa'il al-khalq. Look at Abdullah Umar, after that, what did he say for everyone else? Kun fakana bi, and it all became. Everyone else is kun fayakun. Adam is what? Allah created with his hand. There has to be that the hand here cannot mean qudra or ni'mah. Plus, even if we do take it, and we're going to come to it, Allah's hands are two, and they're both right. Kilta yadayya yaminun, as the messenger said, both of his hands are right. If you take the view which is that the hand here is meant by blessing ni'mah, we'll say to you, so that means Allah's blessings are only two. And where do you take the ayah? إِن تَعُدُّ نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَظَلُومٌ كَفَّارٌ If you sit down and try to count the blessings of Allah, you can't put a number to it. For verily, humans are disbelievers of the blessings that Allah has bestowed upon them. Allah is saying, you can't count my blessings. And you've said that Allah's blessings are two. Because the word, بِيَدَيَّ, that ya is ya'u tathniya. Imam, who understood that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's hands are two? I just brought you the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he said, وَكِلْتَا يَدَيْهِ يَمِينُ. Both of his hands are right. The Prophet said it. Also, Ikrimah, who is the Mawla of Abdullah ibn Abbas, he said, he's a Qurashi al-Hashimi. Sha'bi said, مَا بَقِي أَحَدٌ أَعْلَمُ بِكِتَابِ اللَّهِ مِنْ عِكْرَمَةٍ. Sha'bi said, there's no one who remains on the face of this earth today more knowledgeable than the Book of Allah than Ikrimah. He died in year 104. What did he say? What did he say? When he came to the ayah in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 64, he said, يَدَاهُ مَبَسُوطَتَانِ. Both of his hands are open. What did he say? يَعْنِي, it means, أَلْيَدَيْنِ, two hands. Ikrimah says, yeah, it means 2 days. Now, where's the tafwid? Where's the ta'wil, ya Asha'ira? Where is the tafwid? And where is the ta'wil? Imam Malik, rahimahullah. Imam Malik ibn Anas. I know I promised. Imam Malik, rahimahullah. When a man came to him, he said, ya Aba Abdurrahman, ala al-arshi istawa, kayfa istawa. Allah went above his throne. How did he go above his throne? Imam Malik, rahimahullah, he said, al-kayfu ghayru ma'qulin. The how is not known. It's not something we know. Just because we don't know it doesn't mean Allah doesn't have a how. He does. You just don't know it. وَالِاسْتِوَاءُ, and Allah going above his throne, غَيْرُ مَجْهُولٍ. Look at this. Pay attention. غَيْرُ, it is not majhul. It's not unknown. The istiwa is known in the language he's trying to say to you. In another way, what do you say? He said, وَالِاسْتِوَاءُ مَعْلُومٌ. The istiwa is known in the language. He said it's known. وَالْإِيمَانُ بِهِ وَاجِبٌ. And it's obligatory that you believe in it. How can I believe in something if there's a tafwid in there? How? How do you expect me to believe something I don't know? وَالسُّؤَالُ عَنْهُ بِدْعَةٌ. And the question of asking how Allah went above his throne is a what? It's an innovation. فَإِنِّي أَخَافُ أَن تَكُونَ ضَالًا. Imam Malik said, I'm scared that you are a misguided person. I fear for you أن تَكُونَ ضَالًا, that you're a misguided one. وَأَمَرَ بِهِ فَأُخْرِجَ. He ordered for him to be taken out. He got kicked out. Ibn Abi Mulaika, مثلاً. Ibn Abi Mulaika, Abdullah ibn Ubaidullah ibn Abi Mulaika, who said, أدركت 30 من الصحابة. I met 30 of the companions. And Abu Hatim, he said, he's a thiqa. He died the year 117. When he was asked, عن يد الله, Allah's hands, أواحدة أو اثنتان. Is Allah's hand one or two? He said, بل اثنتان, they are two. الدارمي narrated in his kitab, نقض بشر المريسي, سعد بن أبي مريم, عن نافع الجمحي, and the chain of narration is authentic. The same thing. Waleed ibn al-Muslim, he said, سألت الأوزاعية, I asked أوزاعي, and Sufyan al-Thawri, and Malik ibn Anas, and Layth ibn Sa'ad. I asked them about the hadith of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala's characteristics. I asked them. فَكُلُّهُمْ, all of them, they said, أَمِرُّهَا, go over it, كَمَا جَاءَتْ, the way it came. Go over it, read it, go over it, without giving it any how. Brothers, I know I said, I know I said, but this is very important to read Imam Tirmidhi's kalam in his jami'. That Tirmidhi said, and it's very important that we study, Tirmidhi, who is a student of Imam al-Bukhari, rahimahullah, great knowledgeable alim we know. He died the year 279. He said, Muhammad ibn Isa Tirmidhi. You can say Tirmidhi or you can say Turmudhi. Both, no problem. And Imam al-Tirmidhi, rahimahullah, he said it in his jami', Kitab al-Zakat, when he came to Babu Fadl al-Sadaqah, the virtue of Sadaqah. Look what he said. When he came, he was talking about the hadith, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ الصَّدَقَةَ. Allah accepts your charity. وَيَأْخُذْهَا, and he takes it, بِيَمِينِهِ, with his right. فَيُرَبِّيهَا, and Allah nurtures it for you. He said, وَقَدْ قَالَ غَيْرُ وَاحِدٍ مِنْ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ. It was said from more than one of the scholars of the people of ilm. في هذا الحديث, regarding this hadith, meaning what hadith is referring to, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَقْبَلُ الصَّدَقَةَ وَيَأْخُذْهَا بِيَمِينِهِ فَيُرَبِّيهَا. Allah takes the sadaqah, and accepts it, and he takes it with his right, and he nurtures it. وَمَا يَشْبِهُ هَذِهِ الرِّوَايَةِ, and anything that is like it, وَمَا يُشْبِهُ هَذَا الرِّوَايَةِ, and anything that resembles these narrations from the characteristics of Allah, all the other narrations that are resembling of this, because the word بِيَمِينِهِ, Allah's hand is in there. Such as what? نُزُولُ الرَّبِّ, Allah coming down, تَبَارَكْ وَتَعَالَى, كُلَّ لَيْلَةٍ, every night to the world, to the earth. قالت قالوا they said he's talking about who the people of ilm he's a salaf he's at the time of the salaf he said they said the salaf said قالوا they said قد تثبت الرواية في هذا narrations are authentically regarding can be narrated ويؤمن بها ويؤمن بها and it's believed in ولا يتوهم and one does not become deluded on it ولا يقال and no one can say كيف how did Allah come down how does Allah come down the last third of the night how they ask us all the time if the world is like this he says to you he brings a thing he takes you if the world is this yeah and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is here and then the world is here كيف how you ask us Allah told us subhanahu wa ta'ala Allah told us, the Prophet ﷺ told us that Allah comes down the last third of the night. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala told us he's above the throne. Ar-Rahmanu ala al-Arshi istawa. Ya qawm, don't let these people fool you. They can't understand the hadith. Knowing Allah's characteristics and how Allah does things is something that our minds will never come to understand. We can't even understand what? What can't we even understand? We can't even understand the sun. The sun, is which is a creation. What's the sun? It's a creation. The Prophet ﷺ told us that the sun prostrates to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. What does it do? It prostrates to Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. And it takes permission. It says, Ya Rab, shall I come out from the way I used to come out? From the right, the direction I used to come out from? Or shall I come out from the opposite direction? Meaning, let the hour strike. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says to the sun, nope, carry on your daily routine. Do as you used to do. That sun, somebody can come and say, pay attention. This sun, when it's night for us, it's day for another country. So when does it talk to Allah? You can't even understand the sun, ya qawm. You can't even understand the sun. How do you wish to understand Allah tabarak wa ta'ala? We will say, Allah and understanding Him is something we cannot do. Tirmidhi is saying to you, Allah coming down and all these characteristics. Don't say, cave, how? You see, مثلاً, these Ahlul Bida', what do? They take something and they say, Allah, cave, and they're trying to ask you how. When are you qalu cave? No one can say how. We believe in it. هكذا روي عن مالك. That's the same. He's saying to you, this all of that I'm saying is what Imam Malik said. وسفيان, and this is what Sufyan ibn Uyayna said. وعبدالله ibn Mubarak said. And now قالوا that they all said. في هذه الأحاديث regarding all these hadith of the attributes and the characteristics of Allah. What did they say? أمروها go over it. بلا كيف without giving a how to it. When they say go over it, it means stick to its apparent Arabic meaning in it. That's what they mean. وَهَكَذَا قَوْلُ أَهْلِ الْعِلْمِ مِنْ أَهْلِ السُّنَّةِ And this is the speech from the what? The people of the Sunnah. وَأَمَّا الْجَهْمِيَّةِ Pay attention. As for the Jahmiyyah, what did they do? فَأَنْكَرَتْ هَذِي الرِّوَايَةِ They said, we don't affirm all these characteristics. Pay attention to this, yeah? It's important. The Jahmiyyah, they said, we don't believe in these characteristics that are mentioned. Allah coming the last day, last third of the night. We don't believe it. Wallah, you hear that in the Asha'ira saying it today. وَقَالُوا Tirmidhi is talking. What did he say? When the Jahmiyyah, they negate and they refuse to accept Allah's characteristics, what did they say? They say, هَذَا تَشْبِيُّهُنْ The reason why we don't take it is because it is what? تَشْبِي What comes out from it is what? تَشْبِي If we say Allah is a hand, automatically what's going to come out from it is what? Allah and His creations both have hands and then it's going to look like the same. هَيَا تَشَبَهَدْ قُلُوبُهُمْ Exactly, عين قول الجهمية. It is exactly what the Jahmiyyah said, is what Hanafi channel and the likes of them choose to say. I'm still reading the kalam of who? Tirmidhi. And I'm going to end it with this. وَقَدْ ذَكَرَ اللَّهُ عَزَّ وَجَلَّ And he said, Allah mentions in في غير موضع, in more than one place. من كتابي in his book. اليد hand. وَالسَّمْعَ hearing. وَالْبَصَرَ and eyesight. فَتَأَوَّلَتِ الْجَهْمِيَّةِ The Jahmiyyah, they done ta'wil on it. Allahu Akbar. They done ta'wil. They distorted it. هذه الآيات All these ayat. Somebody might come here and say, oh brother, the Asha'ira, the ta'wil that Tirmidhi is talking about is distortion. He's talking, ta'wil can be tahrif, distortion. They distorted it by saying, what is it? Qudra, ni'ma, and the likes of it. He's going to mention himself. I'm not going to say it for him. He's going to say exactly himself. فَفَسَّرُوهَا They explained it. عَلَى غَيْرِ مَا فَسَّرَ أَهْلُ الْعِلْمِ They explained it other than the people of knowledge the way they explained it. Meaning the Sahabas and Tabi'in. Hey, what did they say to Tirmidhi? وَقَالُوا They said, the Jahmiyyah, إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَمْ يَخْلُقَ Allah did not create Adam بيدي. Allah did not create Adam with his hand. وَقَالُوا They said, إِنَّ مَعْنَ الْيَدْ That the hand, the meaning behind it is what? هَا هُنَا In this verse is what? الْقُوَّةِ ability. Jahmiya. So it's saying that the ayat of Allah is meant by quwwah. That's the call of the Jahmiya. That's tafsir al-Jahmi. That's the tafsir of Jahmi. وقال إسحاق, pay attention, Ibn Ibrahim, this is still the kalam of who? Tirmidhi. Tirmidhi brings the speech of who? Ishaq ibn Rahuya. You guys know him. Ishaq ibn Rahuya was the Shaykh al-Imam al-Bukhari. Imam al-Bukhari is Shaykh al-Bukhari. Imam al-Bukhari's teacher, Ishaq ibn Rahuya. And he was one of the people who brought the thought to Bukhari's mind in order to do what? To write the Sahih, in according to one of the views. That he brought the idea to Bukhari to write his Sahih. Look what he said. إِنَّمَا يَكُونُ التَّشْبِيهُ. When is it tashbih? Ya qawm, please, brothers. Wallahi, this is important. إِنَّمَا يَكُونُ التَّشْبِيهُ. It becomes a tashbih, meaning you are doing tashbih of Allah's characteristics. When does it become? إِذَا قَالَ, when the person says, يَدٌ, Allah has a hand. كَيَدٍ, like the hand. Yeah, that's a resemblance. Oh, مِثْلَ يَدٍ, or the like of this hand. So you're saying Allah's hand is like my one. Or Allah's hand is the like of so-and-so's hand. Or Allah's hand looks like hand of this. Oh, yeah. Oh, sam'un, or Allah hears, kasam'in, like the hearing of this. Or mithla sam'in, or the likes of this hearing. فَإِذَا قَالَ سَمِعْ. But if the person says, sam'un, kasam'in, or mithla sam'in, فَهَذَا تَشْبِيه. That is tashbih. So say Allah's hearing is like this hearing. Allah's seeing is like this seeing. That is tashbih. Is Haq ibn Rahuya saying this? But if the person says, وَأَمَّا إِذَا قَالَ, but if the person says, كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَ, as Allah said, يَدٌ, Allah has a hand, وَسَمْعٌ, Allah has a, Allah can hear, وَبَصَرٌ, Allah can see, وَلَا يَقُولُ, and he doesn't say, كيف, how Allah can see, how Allah's hand is, and how Allah تبارك وتعالى hears, وَلَا يَقُولُ, and he doesn't say, مِثْلَ سَمْعٍ, like the hearing, وَلَا كَسَمْعٍ, or like the hearing, فَهَذَا لَا يَكُونُ تَشْبِيهًا. That person is not doing tashbih. وَهُوَ كَمَا قَالَ تَعَالَى, and that person is accordance to that which Allah said, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ, وَهُوَ السَّمِيعُ الْبَصِيرُ. Allah, there is nothing like him, and Allah is the all-hear and the all-seer. And Tirmidhi's kalam, it's in his jami', which I quoted, Kitabu Zakat, Babu Ma Ja'a Fi Fadl Sadaqah. So inshallah ta'ala, any person who needs to know more about the Asha'ira, inshallah ta'ala, once in a sit or so, inshallah, I will mention it. But brothers, the qadiyya, Allah's characteristics, to be affirmed according to Ahlul Sunnah, it is that their ta'wil and tafwid is not allowed. And Allah's characteristics are haqiqatan. They are literal. And they befit him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. They what? Befit him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's an ijma'. The ijma' was quoted by Imam Abu Umar At-Talmankiyu al-Malikiyu, rahimahullah. He said, وَقَالَ أَهْلُ السُنَّةِ فِي قَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى. أَهْلُ السُنَّةِ said, regarding the speech of Allah, الرَّحْمَنُ عَلَى الْعَرْشِ اسْتَوَى. Allah went above his throne. What did he say? إِنَّ الْإِسْتِوَاءَ مِنَ اللَّهِ عَلَى عَرْشِ عَلَى الْحَقِيقَةِ. It's in its literal. لَا عَلَى الْمَجَازِ. And it's not a majaz. It's not metaphorical. فَقَدْ قَالَ قَوْمٌ مِنَ الْمُعْتَزِلَةِ وَالْجَهْمِيَةِ. Some of the Mu'tazila, قَوْمٌ مِنَ الْمُعْتَزِلَةِ. A group of people, such as the Mu'tazila and the Jahmiya, they said, لَا يَجُوزُ, it is not permissible, and يُسَمَّ اللَّهُ, that Allah تبارك وتعالى is called بِهَذِهِ الْأَسْمَاءِ, by these names, at its literal meaning. But he said, وَقَالَ أَهْلُ السُنَّةِ, أَهْلُ السُنَّةِ said, كَأَنَّ إِجْمَعُ أَهْلُ السُنَّةِ. That's the view of أَهْلُ السُنَّةِ. الإمام السجزي رحمه الله تعالى, in his كتاب الرد على من أنكر الحرف والصوت, he also mentions, الواجب أن يعلم, it is obligatory for one to know, أن الله تعالى إذا وصف نفسه بصفة, it is obligatory for one to know, that if Allah describes himself with a characteristics, هي معقولة عند العربي, it is known, it is something known to the Arabs, they know the meaning of it, والخطاب, the addressing, ورد عليها عليهم, and the addressing is targeted at the people who understand the Arabic language, the word, it has its Arabic meaning, بما يتعارفون بينهم, which they knew amongst themselves. ولم يبين سبحانه أنها بخلاف ما يعقلون. And Allah did not mention that the characteristics of his goes opposite to what the Arabs understand. Allah didn't say, Arabs, you guys know yad, right? It's not what you guys understand as the word yad. It's something else. Allah didn't say that. ولا فسرها النبي. The Prophet didn't give it a meaning and say, the tafsir here means what, brothers? The tafsir here means the distortion of putting it. لما أداها بتفسير يخالف ظاهرة تفسير that goes against the apparent or opposes the apparent meaning فهي على ما يعقلونه ويتعرفونه. The matter is what the Arabs knew and was unknown amongst them. والذي يوضح ذلك. What clarifies the matter more? And inshallah, you can go back to his kitab. Wallahi, it's a nukatin, latifatin, that he mentions regarding that matter. I hope I have shone light and I explained it very well for all of you to understand. أن الأشاعرة, that the أشاعرة ليسوا من أهل السنة. They are not from أهل السنة. They are not from أهل السنة لا من قريب ولا من بعيد. They're not from far nor close. Nothing to do with أهل السنة. أهل السنة في واد. أهل السنة is in a valley وهم في واد. And they are in another valley. Day and night. As for they claiming that we're أهل السنة, that we say, كل يدعي وصلا بليلة وليلة لا تقرهم بذلك. Everyone claims Layla's relationship. Layla has nothing to do with them. So that's what it is. It's just a مجرد دعوة. It's just a mere claim. عند نزول الميدان, once we come down to the field and we researched, we find that they have no relation to it. I hope I've explained that matter very well. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليك.